Batting first and playing second base, number 21, Bailey King. Batting second and playing center field, number 4, Caitlin Province. Batting third, the catcher, number 26, Aaron Williams. Batting fourth, the designated player, number 8, Lauren Lester. Batting fifth, the first baseman, number 77, Tuesday Melton. Batting sixth, the right field, number 25, Jordan Merritt. Batting seventh, the left field, number 34, Emily Reed. Batting eighth, the third baseman, number 1, Remington Adams. And batting ninth, the shortstop, number 6, Abby Reams. In the circle for game 3, the right-handed pitcher, number 20, Jaden Galindo. Now the starters for your Southern Arkansas Mule Riders. Batting first, the designated player, number 65, Reagan Dillon. Batting second, the center field, number 3, Ariana Roll. Batting third, the second baseman, number 14, Cameron Moctezuma. Batting fourth, the first baseman, number 18, Jenna Huey. Batting fifth, the catcher, number 23, Haley Millen. Batting sixth, the third baseman, number 5, Gracie King. Batting seventh, the right field, number 10, Bella Angelo. Batting eighth, the shortstop, number 7, Cassidy Lear. And batting ninth, the left field, number 2, Morgan McAlexander. And in the circle for the Mule Riders in game 3, the right-handed pitcher, number 55, Brinson Rogers. Mule Riders are coached by Jason Anderson. His assistants are Mandy Jordan, Molly Carter, and Kristen Dalton. Today's starting lineups have been brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Domino's Pizza, the official pizza provider of the Mule Riders. And now, fans, at this time, will you please stand and remove all headgears? We honor America with the playing of the national anthem. Circle for game 3 for the Mule Riders. The right-handed pitcher, number 55, Brinson Rogers, and her battery partner, the catcher, number 23, Haley Millen.
Hello, softball fans, and a happy Saturday morning to all of you as we are here live from the Dawson Field inside the Dr. Margaret Downing Softball Complex. Game 3 of this Great American Conference series is underway. As Southern Arkansas looks to finish off Ouachita. And first pitch to Ouachita leadoff Bailey King is popped up. The bunt's popped up and caught by SAU starter Brinson Rogers. So popped up the bunt back to Rogers in the circle, and it's a quick first out.
Now batting the center fielder number 4, Caitlin Province.
For the Tigers as Caitlin Province steps to the plate. Aaron Williams in the 3 spot. And again, Rogers in the circle for Southern Arkansas. Went the distance yesterday in the opener, 7 innings pitched. Allowed 4 hits, an earned run, walked 1, and struck out 15. Fifth time this year she's moved over the 10-plus strikeout mark in the game. And it's a two-ball, no-strike count to Caitlin Province. Swings through that pitch for strike number one. The defense for Southern Arkansas, the battery made of Rogers, is Haley Nillen. Gracie King's at third. Cassie Lears at shortstop. Cameron Moctezuma at second. And Jenna Huey at first to round out the infield for the Mule Riders. The 2-1 pitch inside part of the plate for a called strike. And Rogers evens the count against Province. Two balls, two strikes. In the outfield, Morgan McAlexander made her debut in the field yesterday for Southern Arkansas. She's in left. Ariana Roll, familiar face in center field for SAU, and Bella Angelo in right field. 2-2 pitch misses up, and the count runs full to the second batter to the plate here in the top of the first inning, Caitlin Province. Full count pitch, pulled the string just slightly, the off speed gets Province to swing through it for out number two in the first strikeout of the afternoon for Brinson Rogers.
Batting the catcher number 26, Aaron Williams.
Sun was shining about 2 hours prior to game time, since overcast day now. Wind coming out of the southwest like it was yesterday, around 8 to 10 miles an hour. Gust up to 15. Didn't really see the wind play too much of a role in yesterday's doubleheader. Southern Arkansas took the first game of the series 7-1 in seven innings and then capped off the day with a 10-0 run rule victory over the Tigers. One ball, one strike to count to Aaron Williams. Williams went 4-for-5 in yesterday's doubleheader. Also drew a walk. Was the top hitter for the Tigers across 12 innings of action on Friday. One ball, two strikes, two away here in the top of the first inning. Pitch misses for ball two. Delivers the 2-2, swing and a miss, strike three. A 2K inning for Brinson, and it's a 1-2-3 frame for the Tigers as Dylan Roll and Moctezuma are up for SAU in the home half of the first.
In the top of the first inning, there were no runs, no hits, no errors, and no runners left on base. Circle for the Tigers in game three, the right-handed pitcher number 20, Jaden Galindo, and her battery partner behind the plate, the catcher number 26, Aaron Williams. Leading off for the Mule Riders in game three, the designated player number 65, Reagan Dillon.
Reagan Dillon in the box to lead things off for Southern Arkansas on the Mule Riders' first trip to the plate here in game three of this Great American Conference series. The first pitch she sees from Ouachita starter Jaden Galindo is in there for a called strike. Dylan Rowland, Moctezuma, 1-2-3 for Southern Arkansas, and that's going to get in the gap, right center field. Dylan digging for two, and she will be in there standing up. Reagan Dylan with a double. And that sets the table nicely for Ariana Roll.
Now batting the center field, number three, Ariana Roll.
Bailey King, the Ouachita second baseman, it looked like she had moved just slightly to her right before the pitch, and then Dylan went back to King's left on the ground ball, and it went all the way to the warning track to the fence, and Dylan's in a second standing up. First pitch to Roll. That's slapped out to left field. And caught near the line for out number one.
Now batting and playing second base, number 14, Cameron Moctezuma.
Now Cameron Moctezuma will step to the plate. Two hits yesterday, one of which was a double. She scored a run and drove in three RBI. First pitch to Moctezuma from Galindo, misses for ball one. That was the 11th double of the season for one Reagan Dillon. Her 21st extra base hit. It's a runner in scoring position for the Mule Riders here early in the bottom of the first inning. The 1-1 pitch to Cameron, that misses up. Jenna Huey on deck for Southern Arkansas. He had a two-hit day on Friday. And that pitch misses as well. So Moctezuma's worked a 3-1 count with one gone and one on for SAU. Tigers used four pitchers yesterday, none of which were Jaden Galindo here, the game three starter. She's walked Cameron Moctezuma to put him at first and second for Jenna Huey.
Now batting and playing first base, number 18, Jenna Huey.
Fourth appearance of the season for Galindo. She's actually making her first start. She tossed five innings, 11 hits, 8 runs, 7 are earned, 1 strikeout, 1 walk. Pitch misses low for ball two. 2 balls, no strikes to Jenna Huey. 2-for-6 yesterday, 2 RBI and a run scored. She also walked once. That one's popped up left field, playable. A couple of steps back and then drifts back in to record the second out of the inning. That was Emily Reed out in left field for the Tigers. So the F7 retires Huey, keeps runners at first and
now
second.
Now batting the catch, number 23, Haley Nillen.
It'll bring Haley Nillen to the plate. 3-for-5 yesterday, a double and a home run, 3 RBI and a run scored. She also walked once, so a very productive day at the plate for Haley Nillen in the 5 spot here in Jason Anderson's order. First pitch from Glendo misses for ball one. We're underway in Arkadelphia. Southern Arkansas looks to grab game 3 from Ouachita in a key baseball series. That one's going to be hit opposite field, and that's going to get down out of the reach of a diving Jordan Merritt. Nillen's going to be digging 3. She clears the bases, so it's going to bring in 2. And Haley Nillen sliding into third safely, a bases clearing triple, and it's a 2-0 Southern Arkansas lead here in the home half of the first.
Now batting and playing third base, number five, Gracie King.
Now Gracie King steps to the plate with Nillen at third base. Haley Nillen's hot weekend at the plate continues. King pops that one up. It's going to get out to the outfield grass, but King is there to retire King on the P4. But Southern Arkansas, they add two in the first. We've played one here in Magnolia. Brinson Rogers back out to the circle for SAU.
In the bottom of the first inning, there were two runs, two hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Leading off the top of the second inning for the Tigers is the designated player, right? Lauren Lester.
Lauren Lester, leadoff batter for Ouachita in the top of the second inning. 4, 5, and 6. Lester played first yesterday for the Tigers. She's in as the designated player here in game 3. Gets her to chase at the 1-0 pitch, up and out for strike one. Not much sun, but a pleasant day at the ballpark. Cattle grazing out behind right field. Good little breeze. Not a bad way to spend the Saturday before Easter. Two balls, one strike to lead off batter here in the second inning. Lauren Lester pitching there for a called strike. Rogers works the count back. Two balls, two strikes. Two strikeout frame for Rogers in the first to bring her weekend total to 17. And that one's going to be hit softly back up the middle. Lear ranges over. Quick throw to Huey at first, and a good defensive play there by Cassidy Lear. Hit softly back up the middle, ranged over to her left, fielded quickly and tossed to Huey for out number one.
Base, number 77, Tuesday Melton.
Now Tuesday Melton. Game 3 first baseman. Saw her as the starter in game 2. She's here in the 5 spot for the Tigers. Looks at the first pitch from Rogers for strike one. One pitch in there for strike two. Rogers, as she did in the series opener, she's filling up the zone nicely here. 20th pitch on the way, and she's already thrown a dozen strikes. The 2 pitch, couldn't get her to chase. But the draw is the first ball. Two pitch misses low. So Melton's worked the count back even at 2 balls, 2 strikes. Two Ball two strike count. Got her to swing through it for strikeout number three on the afternoon and the second out here in the top of the second inning.
Now batting the right fielder, number 25, Jordan Barrett.
Hit foul to or by Jordan Merritt in right field here in game three. She's at the plate with two gone here in the second. Rogers delivers. That one again fouled up and out of play for strike two. Two pitch, swing and a miss, down on strikes. Another two punch out inning for Brinson Rogers. The K count moves to four. Southern Arkansas back to the plate when we come back.
In the top of the second inning, there were no runs, no hits, no errors, and no runners left on base. Leading off the bottom of the second inning for Southern Arkansas, the right fielder, number 10, Bella Angelo.
Bella Angelo, the leadoff batter for Southern Arkansas in the bottom of the second inning. It was a two-run triple off the bat of Haley Nillen. Back in the home half of the first, that's the difference so far in the early going here of game three. Angelo's worked a 2-0 count against Ouachita starter Jaden Galindo. Freshman right-hander making her first start of the season, fifth appearance for the Tigers. Pitch in there for a strike. Angelo went 0-for-1 yesterday, scored twice, also had an RBI, but she was walked four times, so definitely did her part out of that seventh spot of Coach Anderson's order, reaching base. And that one's popped up on the infield. King runs in from second. He'll retire Angelo on the P4 for out number one in the second.
Now batting the shortstop, number seven, Cassidy Lear.
Impressive defensive play for Cassidy Lear back in the top of the second inning, ranging over from that shortstop position to field a ball in the middle, up the middle. He's able to throw over to Huey to record an out. She's up here in the home half of the second. Lear scored three times yesterday. Recorded a hit in the doubleheader. In the eighth spot here in game three, Morgan McAlexander on deck for SAU. The 2-0 pitch. That one's fouled off at the plate. Two balls, one strike. That pitch misses low and in for ball three, so Lear ahead in the count comfortably, 3-1. That one's popped up softly back to Galindo in the circle, and she's got it for out number two. So consecutive infield pop-outs for the Mule Riders. There's a quick two outs
now
on the board.
The left field number two, Morgan McAlexander.
And it brings Morgan McAlexander to the plate. McAlexander yesterday, 2 for 5, 2 RBI, walked once, also scored a run. Her debut at the plate. That pitch misses low from Galindo for ball one. No pitch, a little too far in. Misses for ball two. Alexander can reach to roll the order back over to the top for Reagan Dillon. They're able to do some damage with 2 outs in yesterday's doubleheader. It's McAlexander now ahead in the count, 3 balls, no strikes. And the 3-0 pitch misses, 4-4.
Now batting the designated player, number 65, Reagan Dillon.
So Reagan Dillon steps to the plate. Doubled to lead off that run scoring first inning for Southern Arkansas. Runner to work with here with McAlexander at first base. Galindo, will work to be careful here against Dillon. Good pitch there. Top part of the strike zone to even the count, 1-1. One pitch off speed, hit over to second base. King's got it, tosses over to Melton, and the 4-3 will retire Southern Arkansas in the second. Through two, Southern Arkansas leads by two. Rogers back out to the circle for the Mule Riders.
In the bottom of the second inning, there are no runs, no hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Leading off the top of the third inning for the Tigers, the left field number 34, Emily Reed.
Top of the third underway here in Magnolia, game three of this GAC series between Southern Arkansas and Ouachita. Brinson Rogers back out to work in the circle. For SAU, first pitch, to Ouachita's leadoff batter here in the frame, Emily Reed, the left fielder here in game three. That misses for ball one. Fouled off into the netting, count evens 1-1. Scoreless through one in Arkadelphia, Southern Arkansas and Ouachita in the third game of that baseball series. Similar result in Arkadelphia that we saw here yesterday, SAU taking two from the Tigers. The 1-1 pitch from Rogers in there for a called strike. Pitch misses and the count evens. Two balls, two strikes. The 2-2 pitch swung through it. Strike three. Reed down on strikes. The fifth punch out of the afternoon for Miss Brinson Rogers. She's got 20 on the weekend.
Number one, Remington Adams.
So she's put together herself so far an impressive two-start effort. That one's popped up left field line, and that's going to find some open real estate. And it's a one-out base runner for the Tigers. First hit of the afternoon for Ouachita belongs to the third baseman, Remington Adams.
Now batting the shortstop, number six, Abby Reams.
Kind of a no man's land where Adams placed that one. Too far in for McAlexander to get to, even with her speed. And was hugging the line, so Lear couldn't get there. And was hit just hard enough that it got down before King could make a play. So Adams is at first base. Abby Reams, the freshman shortstop, she's at the plate. And now we've got a little bit of a pickle. Nillen's going to throw down to Lear. And out back at the bag, the 2-6-3 caught stealing for those of you scoring at home. Two pitch misses for ball one. Just like that, a two quick outs. After the one out, base runner is erased. Looked like Adams might have not realized how far off she was when she stopped. And swinging through that one for strike three, retires Ouachita quickly in the third. New Riders to the plate when we come back. It's Roll, Moctezuma, and Huey up for Southern Arkansas.
In the top of the third inning, there are no runs, one hit, no errors, and no runners left on base. Leading off the bottom of the third inning for Southern Arkansas, the center fielder number three, Ariana Roll.
Ariana Roll up for Southern Arkansas here in the bottom of the third inning. Shows bunt there, lays it down, but foul. So she'll head back to the box. Roll, Moctezuma, and Huey. 2-3-4 in the SAU order. We'll see from them here in the third. As SAU tries to add to that 2-0 advantage they put up against Ouachita starter Jaden Galindo back in the first inning. One ball, one strike, the count to Ariana Roll. Roll, that one's going to hit out to left field, just out of the reach. A diving effort by the shortstop, Avi Reams. Rolls on with a leadoff single.
Now batting and playing second base, number 14, Cameron Moctezuma.
Moctezuma steps in from the left side. First pitch from Galindo misses for ball one. Zuma enjoying herself a solid season so far. 327 average entering today's action. 1-0 pitch. That one's going to be fouled up over toward the left side and out of play. The Yuma Arizona product, second on the team in hits with 36. 11 of those went for extra bases. 7 2 baggers, a triple, and 3 of them have left the yard. 24 RBI. Total of 54 bases. She's got a base runner to work with here in the third. Her pitch misses out for ball two. Ariana rolls at first base. Moctezuma's at the plate. Huey in the on-deck circle. That one's going to be slapped over and through the left side, and it gets under the glove of the left fielder. Roll's going to take second. She hits third. She's going to be in safely. Moctezuma all the way to third. Just misplayed the ball. Was set up right there in front of it, and it just went underneath the glove of the left fielder out there for Ouachita, Emily Reed. And I believe that's going to prompt a pitching change here for the Tigers. So I believe the Tigers are going to go back to Hannah Hunter in the circle. We saw her in a starting effort in game one.
Pitching change for Ouachita Baptist. Now in the circle for the Tigers, the right-handed pitcher number zero, Hannah Hunter. And now batting the first baseman, number 18, Jenna Huey.
Great effort by the second baseman, Bailey King, reaching out and snagging that one. The line out
now
by Huey.
Catcher number 23, Haley Millen.
And the first pitch to Haley Millen in there for a called strike. Sal Hanna Hunter yesterday, 4 1/3 innings pitched, 4 hits, 6 runs, 4 of which were earned. Walked 6, struck out 3. She's ahead in the count. No balls, 2 strikes to Haley Nillen. 2-run triple for Nillen back in the first. She's got a runner at third in Moctezuma here with just 1 out in the inning. Hit on the ground, fielded at third, and a good throw across the diamond there by Remington Adams for out number 2.
Now batting and playing third base for 5, Gracie King.
Now Gracie King up with 2 gone, and Moctezuma at third base. Fouled off at the plate for strike 1. Scoreless through 2 in Arkadelphia. Heading top 3. All the Mule Riders and the Tigers. The 0-1 pitch. That misses up. And Moctezuma is going to be able to take the plate for the 4th run of the afternoon for SAU. One ball, 1 strike to Gracie King. Pitch misses low, 4 ball, 2. Fouls that pitch off at the plate and count even at 2 balls, 2 strikes. The Kings work the count full, 3-2 here with 2 outs in the 3rd. Full count pitch and fought off at the plate. King fouls that one over towards the padding on the right side. Count holds full. That's popped up. That's going to drift into the Murata dugout. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming to Gracie King. That one's fouled off into the netting. So King doing her part to stay alive at the plate. And to keep the 2-run frame moving along. She can reach. Angelo will have an at-bat here in the 3rd. Full count pitch again. That one's hit sharply. Left center field gap. It's going to bounce in the warning track and off the wall, and it's a 2-out double off the bat of Gracie King. Good patient hitting there. Got her pitch after fouling off a couple. Puts it in the left center field gap. She's standing on 2nd for Bella Angelo.
Now batting the right fielder, number 10, Bella Angelo.
The 5th double of the season for Gracie King, the 45th. Correction, 47th off the bat of a Mule Rider this campaign as Angelo swings through that pitch. Gracie, contact made. That's going to be right side. And coming in and making a diving effort out there in right field. Nicely done by Jordan Merritt. And that'll retire Southern Arkansas in the third, but not before the Mule Riders push across two more. They lead it 4-0 through three. Brinson Rogers to the circle when we come back.
In the bottom of the third inning, there are two runs, three hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Leading off the top of the fourth inning for the Tigers, playing second base, number 21, Bailey King.
Top of the order up for Ouachita here in the top of the fourth inning. King, Province, and Williams. Rogers is back out to work the fourth. King showed Munn had to pull back as that pitch was inside for ball two. Pitch finds the zone for strike one. So Arkansas pushed across two in the first, two more in the third. And they lead it 4-0 through three innings of action. Outside corner, good placement there from Rogers. Enjoying a six strikeout afternoon so far. Pushes a weekend total to 21. And I'll say this, Jonathan, 21 strikeouts over two starts, really still working in this start. I wouldn't say it's much of a gamble to say she's got to be up for potential player of the week honors. Two pitch, swing and a miss, making number seven for Rogers. As King is down on strikes, that'll bring Province to the plate here with one gone in the fourth.
Now batting the center fielder number four, Caitlin Province.
Showed bunt, and that one's fouled sharply over the top of the press box. One pitch, that misses out. Count evens, one ball, one strike. One pitch, showed bunt, pulled back. Rogers finds that outer black. Two pitch from Rogers, that misses up and in, and the count moves even. Two balls and two strikes. Rogers gets the sign, delivers. Couldn't get Province to chase there, and she's worked the count full at 3-2. That pitch misses out, and Rogers is going to walk Province with one out, put a runner on. That'll bring Aaron Williams to the plate. Four hits for Williams yesterday.
Aaron Williams.
Across two games. The top hitter for the Tigers. She also drew a walk. That one's popped up and off the netting. No balls, one strike to Aaron Williams. Ball one strike to Aaron Williams, top hitter in this Ouachita order. Province is at first base, reached on a walk. One out here in the top of the fourth inning, that's popped up and back over the top and out of play. Misses up. Count's going to go even at two balls, two strikes. Rogers looks at that left wrist, gets the call from Coach Jordan. Delivers a 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Williams down on strikes for out number two here in the fourth.
Now batting the designated player, number eight, Lauren Lester.
Lauren Lester, the designated player, steps to the plate. Two outs now. Check swing. Home plate umpire is going to say she went for strike one. Eight strikeouts to just one hit and one walk allowed by Brinson Rogers through 3 2/3 innings pitched. You know, one pitch misses up. One pitch, that's fouled off softly back into the netting for strike number two. I believe we've got a bat malfunction now as Lester. Changes bats mid at bat. One ball, two strikes. Two outs here in the top of the fourth inning. Pitch from Rogers, again, fouled up and out of play. One ball, two strikes, count to Lester. Just misses out, count's gonna even at 2-2. Popped up and gonna roll down the netting. Hold the count at 2-2. Province is at first base. She drew a walk, the first one issued by Rogers here this afternoon. Six, two, two. That one's going to be hit over to third base. Good fielding there by King, but in foul territory. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming for Lauren Lester. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, top of the fourth. Runner on, that's Province. Rogers gazes into the dugout. And delivers. That one's hit out. And that's going to get down, kind of that Bermuda Triangle out in left center. And so some two-out work being done at the plate here for the Tigers. Moves Province to second. That'll bring Tuesday Melton up.
Now batting and playing first base for 77, Tuesday Melton.
So the second hit of the afternoon for the Tigers goes to Lauren Lester, and now Tuesday Melton's up with two on and two gone here in the fourth. Swing and a miss there from Tuesday. One pitch swung on and missed again. Now Rogers ahead in the count. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Pitch away from getting out of this jam here in the fourth. Could not get Melton to chase at the rise pitch, so it's going to even the count 2-2. Province is at second. Lester's at first for Ouachita. Two-two pitch. Thought about offering up at it. Pulled back for ball three. And so now they're going to check it third. And say she did not. So runners will be off. Full count pitch, swing and a miss. Big punch out there from Brinson Rogers. The biggest of the nine she's had this afternoon. Southern Arkansas back to the plate when we come back.
In the top of the fourth inning, there were no runs, one hit, no errors, and two runners left on base. Leading off the bottom of the fourth inning for Southern Arkansas, the shortstop, number seven, Cassidy Lear.
Cassie Lear, the first batter to the plate for Southern Arkansas here in the bottom of the fourth. Hits that one over to the shortstop, and Lear is safe. I think she might have been through the bag anyway.
Now batting left fielder number two, Morgan McAlexander.
We'll use some video replay to confirm that one. Morgan McAlexander steps in. That's fouled off at the plate. He's down a bunt, and McAlexander threw the bag, trying to get to third, and she moved out of the way. What a move by Lear, trying to get to third. And she appears to be shaken up. She's going to step away from the bag as they call time. Great job by Lear, never let up at second, and then had to move out of the way at
now
of the tag at third.
65, Reagan, Dylan.
That one's popped up by Dylan out to center field, and that one's caught at the warning track, but that'll bring in a run, the fifth run of the game. So Dylan retired on the F8.
Now batting the
sacrifice
center field, number three,
fly.
Ariana, roll.
It'll score Lear. McAlexander holds it first and now rolls at the plate with one out in the inning. That one's hit sharply out to center field, and right there to make the grab. A couple steps to her right is Province on the line out of roll.
Now batting and playing second base for 14, Cameron Moctezuma.
Cameron Moctezuma steps in with two gone here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Hit on the ground and fielded cleanly by Melton. And so the 3U retires McAlexander. But Southern Arkansas pushes across another run in the fourth. They lead it 5-0 through four. Rogers back out to the circle for SAU.
In the bottom of the fourth inning, there's one run, two hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Hitting off the pre-dance bid for Ouachita Baptist, the right foot number 25, George Merritt.
Jordan Merritt, the first batter to the plate for Ouachita here in the top of the fifth inning. Southern Arkansas pushed across a run in the fourth to increase their lead to 5-0. About around the same time, Southern Arkansas pushed across two runs in the fourth inning in Arkadelphia to lead Ouachita 2-0 in game three of the baseball series. Rogers ahead in the count. No balls, two strikes. Leadoff batter for Ouachita here in the fifth, Jordan Merritt.
Yeah.
Two balls, two strikes to count to Merritt. Merritt, Reed, and Adams. 6, 7, and 8 for Ouachita here in the fifth. That one's popped up. Right center field, Angelo's there to retire Merritt for out number one. We've got a pinch hitter here for Emily Reed.
Now pinch hitting for Ouachita Baptist, number 29, Marley Huddleston.
Marley Huddleston, the pinch hitter for Ouachita here with one out in the top of the fifth inning. Rogers goes right at her for strike number one. Hit on the ground. Lear's got it. And a good strong throw over to Huey. And the 6-3 retires Marley Huddleston for out number two in the fifth.
Now batting and playing third base, number one, Remington Adams.
Remington Adams up with two gone here in the top of the fifth inning. Foul out of play. A good pitch by Rogers there. Using that outer half of the plate for strike number two. Some of the teams around the conference were playing their doubleheader today. Just a quick glance at the conference standings. Southern Arkansas currently fifth. That one's fouled. A win here potentially move the New Riders into a tie for fourth place. Balls, two strikes, count to Remington Adams. That one's hit on the line, out to left field, out of the reach of a diving Morgan McAlexander. It's going to be a two-out double. Actually, she's going to try to get a little bit more, and she's going to be thrown out. What a throw by McAlexander as she's able to rally back, get the ball, and toss it into King for the out at third. And so Gracie King shook up at third base. As Jan Kilsgaard will head out to, I believe Adams might have just been one of those plays where you're just trying to slide into the bag and the fielder's trying to make a play, and that's just how it goes. But King is able to jog off on her own power. Great job applying the tag. Great throw by McAlexander. Great effort to potentially even rob of a base hit. So Adams will get credited with a double into left field. But she's going to be thrown out on the 9-5. Jenna Huey to lead things off for Southern Arkansas in the bottom of the fifth inning. Defensive changes.
Fifth for Southern Arkansas, playing first base for 18, Jenna Huey.
Defensive changes for Ouachita. Now in left field, Olivia C. As Hannah Hunter's back in the circle for her third inning of work. Great job there by McAlexander. Diving effort. Got by her. Rolled all the way to the fence. Chases it down and then fires in to get Adams at third for out number three in the inning. One ball, one strike. As Huey swings through that one.
Now batting the catcher, number 23, Haley Nillen.
Jenna Huey's retired on the foul out down the left field line. Call by the left fielder, Olivia C., who just entered the game. Now Haley Nillen's up, swings through that first pitch for strike number one. Tries a checker swing there. Fouls it off near the SAU dugout. And that one's hit on a line. Nillen has been seeing the softball well this weekend. That one just happened to end up right in the glove of Tuesday Melton.
Third base, number five, Gracie King.
For out number two. King pops that one up, and that one's going to get down just out of the reach of Melton, and King's going to be able to take second on the double out to right center field. Just out. I tell you what, we've seen some really good defense being played. Great efforts being made all around. It was just out of the reach of Melton. Or excuse
now
me, Merritt.
Right field number 10, Bella Angelo.
Just out of the reach of Jordan Merritt. All for glove and allows King to get the second on the double. Now Angelo up to face Hunter. First pitch to Bella, misses for ball one. Hit into right field. A couple of steps back is Merritt. She's got it for the F9 to end the inning for Southern Arkansas. Through five, Southern Arkansas leads at 5-0. Rogers back out to the circle to start the sixth.
Pitching fans, pitching change for Southern Arkansas. Now in the circle, the right-handed pitcher, number 13, Sydney Ward.
Brinson Rogers is not out to work the sixth inning. That will be handed over to Sydney Ward. Picked up a win in game two yesterday. So Rogers' day ends. Five innings pitched, just three hits allowed, walked only one, struck out nine to run her weekend.
Sixth inning for the Tigers.
Strikeout count.
Abby Abrams.
To 24. 24 strikeouts for Brinson Rogers across 12 innings of work. So two strikeouts an inning for Brinson Rogers. Very impressive for the Southern Arkansas junior. That one's bunted at the plate, but foul by Avi Reams. 9-1-2 up for Ouachita here in the top of the sixth inning. Three hits for the Tigers. Still looking for that first run of the afternoon. And they'll be tasked with pushing it across against Sydney Ward. That one's laid down. King in sharply. Good throw over to Huey. And the 5-3 put out will bring Bailey King to the plate for Ouachita.
Now batting and playing second base, number 21, Bailey King.
Sydney Ward making just her second relief appearance of the season. 20th appearance overall, just second in a relief effort. As she started her 18th game of the season in yesterday's second half of the twin bill. One oh pitch in there for a strike to Bailey King. One pitch. That one's chopped over, and that's off the glove of King. And that's going to be a single for Bailey King.
Now batting in the center fielder before Caitlin Province.
And now Caitlin Province digs in with a runner on. It was one out in the top of the sixth inning. Pitch in there for a called strike. Still 2-0 Southern Arkansas on top of Ouachita in game three in Arkadelphia. Two outs for the Mule Riders in the top of the fifth inning. Pitch that's in there for strike two. So two balls, two strikes to Caitlin Province. One out here with one on in the sixth. It's just missed. Strike three looking as Province for out number two. Ward picks up her first strikeout of the afternoon, her 93rd of the season.
Now batting the catcher number 26, Aaron Williams.
And that'll bring Aaron Williams, the three-hole hitter. to the plate for Ouachita. Pitch misses up for ball one. Swing and a miss comes up empty. So it's one ball, one strike count. With two outs in the bottom, or excuse me, top of the sixth inning. Runner on, that's King. That's chopped back to Ward. Good job letting that one kind of just bounce into the glove. And a quick throw over to first. 1-3 retires the Tigers. They strand a runner. Southern Arkansas carries a 5-0 lead to the bottom of the sixth. This is Murrah softball.
In the top of the sixth inning, there are no runs, one hit, no errors, and one runner left on base.
I don't know, you keep butchering it though. Cassidy Lear leading things off for Southern Arkansas in the home half of the sixth inning. 8-9-1.
Shortstop number 7, Cassidy Lear.
Up for the Mule Riders. And their sixth trip to the plate. 5 runs on the board for SAU, courtesy of 8 hits, as well as 2 walks. And the first pitch to Cassidy Lear misses for ball one. Arkansas trying to close out the series, earn that sweep, which will move them to 13-7 in Great American Conference play, and have them nestled right there, smack dab in the middle of the Great American Conference standings. Pitch to Lear in there for called strike. 2 balls, 1 strike to Cassidy. From here, the Mule Riders will hit the road. Play 3 games next weekend in Russellville against Arkansas Tech the following Tuesday. They'll head to Monticello for a doubleheader. The first one of that series will be a conference game. And then they'll return back to Magnolia on April 12th and 13th for 3 games against Southwestern Oklahoma. And the 2-2 pitch is hit back up the middle by Cassidy Lear, and it's a leadoff single for the Southern Arkansas shortstop.
Now batting the left field, number 2, Morgan McAlexander.
Fouled back off into the netting. No balls, 1 strike to McAlexander. Pretty impressive what she's been able to do this weekend. Hasn't played in the field really any in her time at Southern Arkansas, primarily a pitcher. And picked up her fielding glove and her bat for the first time as a Mule Rider. Has done well out there in left field. 1 ball, 1 strike count to Morgan. Hardy swing through that pitch. Comes up empty at 1-2. Pitch misses. Count's going to even at 2 balls, 2 strikes. Two pitch popped up, fouled over near the farm road. Two balls, two strikes to Morgan McAlexander. Second batter to the plate for Southern Arkansas here in the sixth. Lear reached on a leadoff single, and McAlexander on a line out to center field. Good piece of hitting, but just right there, a couple of steps in a hurry was Province.
Now batting
for the LA first out of the inning.
Reagan Dillon.
Now Reagan Dillon, top of the order for Southern Arkansas, with Lear at first base. And the wild pitch is going to move Lear to second. The 1-0 pitch is in there for a called strike. 1 ball, 1 strike. One out, one on for Reagan Dillon, the leadoff batter for Southern Arkansas. Balls, one strike, that misses in. So Dillon ahead in the count, 3-1. That's hit through the left side. Hard piece of hitting there from Reagan Dillon, her second hit of the afternoon. And it moves Lear to third, and they're at the corners for Ariana Roll. So Ava Dunn will take over for Dillon at first.
Fans pinch running for Southern Arkansas at first base. Number 30, Ava Dunn. And now batting the center field, number 3, Ariana Roll.
First pitch to Roll, misses for ball one. So Dunn is going to steal second. Ball at the plate. Dunn will steal second. She'll advance on the error, and then Lear will advance on the throwing error by the catcher. And now Dunn's going to tag on the shallow fly out into the left It took the center fielder to the ground on the line drive, and a great job by Dunn.
Now batting and playing second base, number 14, Cameron Moctezuma.
And now with two outs, Cameron Moctezuma is at the plate. 7-0 ball game. First pitch to Moctezuma misses. Balls, no strikes to Cameron Moctezuma. That pitch misses low for ball three. And a four pitch walk drawn by Moctezuma. That'll bring Huey to the plate. So Southern Arkansas trying to keep it alive with two outs here. Moctezuma's run would end it early, even if by just half an inning. So I believe we're going to have a pinch runner here.
Attention fans, pinch running for Southern Arkansas at first base. Number 11, Emily Donovan.
And now Emily Donovan will take over base running.
And
duties
now batting
at
first
base,
number 18, Jenna Huey.
First pitch to Huey misses out for ball one. It's going to be popped up out to right center field. And it's going to be caught for out number three. And so we will go to the seventh with Southern Arkansas leading 7-0. We'll see Sydney Ward hopefully work the final half inning for Southern Arkansas.
In the bottom of the sixth inning, there are two runs, two hits, one error, and one runner left on base. Now batting the designated player number 8, Lauren Lester.
Designated player Lauren Lester leading things off for Ouachita. Here in the top of the 7th inning, Sydney Ward out. Trying to finish off the Tigers here in game 3. First pitch to Lester misses for ball 1. Out over into the New Rider bullpen. One ball, one strike count from Ward to Lester. 1-1 pitch. That's fouled off at the plate. Two strikes, three straight pitches fouled off by Lester. One, two pitch misses out. Count's going to even 2-2. Swung on and foul down the right side. So credit Lester staying alive at the plate. Got the extra softball situation figured out. Two balls, two strikes. Again, fouled off at the plate. Lester doing her part to try to give the Tigers a leadoff base runner here in the seventh. Misses low, is in the turf. So the count's moved full to Lauren Lester. Four-hole hitter, leadoff batter here for Ouachita in the seventh. The 2 pitch, that's going to be hit on a line out into right center field. And so good patient hitting there from Lester. And it's a leadoff single. Huddleston will pinch hit here, and we'll also have a pinch runner as Emma McCorkle will take
pitch
over.
Pinch running for Ouachita Baptist at first base, number 5, Emma McCorkle. Now pinch hitting for the Tigers, number 7, Maggie Huddleston.
So McCorkle takes over at first base. Maggie Huddleston will pinch hit here for Ouachita. Nobody out. One on for the Tigers. One oh pitch, that's popped up, fouled over the top for strike number 1. One pitch, that misses out for ball 2. 2-1 pitch chopped on the ground. King's got it. She's going to go to second to get the lead runner. Good play there by Gracie King as Huddleston will reach on the fielder's choice. McCorkle's out 5-4. That'll bring Jordan Merritt to the plate.
Now batting the right fielder, number 25, Jordan Merritt.
Steps in. Wood misses out for ball one. One out here in the seventh, so Arkansas just needs two more to earn the sweep over the Tigers. That one's chopped but foul. As King fields it over near the Ouachita dugout. One pitch, swing and a miss. Good location there by Ward. Merritt comes up empty. One ball, two strikes, one out, one on. That one's off the glove of Ward. And just a good play there by Lear to even have a chance at the runner. So it's going to be an infield single.
Now batting the left fielder, number 12, Olivia C.
And now Olivia C. checked in the game in left field an inning ago. She'll have her first at bat of the series. Opportunity here for the Tigers. First pitch to C in there for a called strike. And again, just about the same spot. So Ward ahead in the count, no balls, two strikes. Pair of base runners on for the Tigers. And swing and a miss, three pitches to C. Looks at two, swings at the third one, and it's a second out for Ward and Company here as they're just one out away from closing out the weekend.
Pair of base number one, Remington Adams.
Pitch there from Ward. Remington Adams steps in. Sophomore third baseman. Two runners to work with. Tigers down to their final out of the game. And that one's off the glove of Ward as that was back up the middle. That's going to scratch one run and into second safely, or excuse me, third safely. Adams will hold. Merritt's going to get to third. Huddleston scores one RBI.
Now pinch hitting for the Tigers, number 22, Kennedy Wilkie.
So it's starting to come together for Ouachita here in the seventh. A couple of just a bad luck. Credit Ouachita for hard hit softballs, but two have went off of Ward's glove and just more of a reactionary response. And that one's going to be popped up, but a lot of spin on it, and it'll get foul. That's Kennedy Wilkie's the pitch hitter for Ouachita here in the seventh. Two outs, two on. They're at the corners. Tigers pushed across their first run of the afternoon, second of the series. Ward looks at the left wrist, as do her infielders. And she delivers outside corner. Good placement there for strike two. And now the Tigers down to their final strike. The 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss in the dirt, tagged by Nillen, and that will do it. KS2U, and that is all she wrote for this three-game Great American Conference series. Southern Arkansas takes game three by a final score of 7-1. They take the series 3-0, and they're back in action here April 12th and 13th for a three-game series against Southwestern Oklahoma. We thank you for joining us this weekend. Hope you enjoy the rest of your Saturday. And have a happy Easter.
The New Riders will be back here at Dawson Field for April 12th through 13th for their series against Southwestern Oklahoma State. Trials, thinking everything's perfect. The crowd stone.